CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 5.
Hello children, how are you? I hope you guys are enjoying your work. I am Gitanjali. Today I am taking chapter 2 of class 5. The name of this chapter is Shapes and Angles. This is the second episode of the chapter, which will be taken by me. In today's episode, we will learn about angles present in nature. We will be learning about the angles in our names. We will also learn about the importance of angles in structures of building and monument. Why triangle has a special place in shapes and angles. As per the last episode, you must have observed various angles in your surroundings. Have you seen the angles between your fingers? And what about the angles present in your house? The angle made between door and floor. So basically, wherever there are two lines joined together at one common point, they make an angle. Till now, you must have made angle tester of your own with the help of two cardboard strips. Let me remind you, the angle tester, two cardboard strips that are joined together with a drawing pin so that both the strips can move freely. Have you used that angle tester to check the size of angles? You must have found the angles with the shape L in many objects of your school bag, like your geometry box or your notebook. The angle having shape of English alphabet L is called the right angle. This is the easiest way to remember the right angle. With the help of angle tester, we can easily check the angles less than right angle and the angles more than right angle. Do you remember the names of these angles? Let's just revise the names of different types of angles. The angle which are smaller than right angle are called acute angle. Their shape is like English alphabet V. So this V can be a little wide, but it can never look like L, the right angle. But you can have this V-like shape in any direction. What about the angles greater than right angle? The angles greater than right angles are called obtuse angle. Can you think of any specific letter that could look like obtuse angle? It is there in English alphabet X, the capital X, where you just need to rotate the X. You can see two arms of the angles are wider than L shape right angle. So this is how we can remember the size of different types of angle with the help of English alphabets. Today, the purpose of our session is to find out the hidden angles in our environment and play with them. So we will be going to angle garden where lots of angles are already waiting for us. You only need to identify the angles. Now, welcome to the angle garden. Let's start with an activity. For this activity, you need to bring some leaves from the garden, or if you have plants at your home, you can take leaves from there too. So, I am giving you 5 minutes to bring the following things to start the activity. In between, get your leaves ready. For this activity, we need some leaves, watercolor, brush, water, and your angle tester. What we have to do now we need to color the leaves using watercolor. Then take print of the leaves on your notebook. Can you see the angles in the print? Observe the angle between the lines of leaves and find out which of them is making a right angle, greater than right angle, or smaller than right angle. You might have seen the design of leaves on clothes too. You can see the angles in those designs. Since we are talking about angle garden, have you observed the branches of plants that are joined together? They also have angles. All of you must have heard the story of crow having food in his beak. He has a piece of roti in his beak and was sitting on the tree. As soon as the fox came to manipulate him for the roti, fox started praising the singing talent of the crow. And the crow decided to sing. And finally, he opened his mouth and the roti fell down. So when it opened the mouth, it was the beak that made an angle. Now, can you imagine the size of angle of crow's beak? So, the birds also have angles in their beak. Think of the names of various birds and find out the size of angle of their beak. I would like you to write down the names of the birds which have beak with a small angle. In a garden, lots of things have angles. It can be leaves of the plants, branches of the tree, petals of the flower, ray of the sun, dance of the bees, etc. It's so fascinating indeed. Let us now have another activity to look for more angles. The name of the activity is Angles in the Name. For this activity, you need some amount of matchsticks. You can also have a colored sheet and Fevicol if you want to make a wall hanging craft having various angles. So, we may have a showpiece or a wall hanging with the help of mathematics. I hope you have brought the matchstick. So, we can start now. First of all, we will practice with a common name. Let's take the name Aman. You have to use matchsticks to write the letters of the name Aman. A-M-A-N. This is a four-letter word that we are taking. One of the easiest name too. Have you finished writing the letter Aman? Make sure the matchsticks are joined together and touch the end of other matchsticks. Now, let's make a table to write down the number of angles. The table should have four columns. Title of the first column will be Name. The title of the second column is Right Angle. Title of the third column is Less than right angle, or you can write acute angle. Title of the fourth column will be more than right angle or obtuse angle. Now you and I will identify and count various types of angles. If you have finished writing Aman, please mark the angles you can see in each alphabet in the matchsticks joined together. As you can see, the number of angles in A are 3. The number of angles in M are 3. The number of angles in N are 2. Now, we will fill the table by identifying the types of angle. The name is A-M-A-N. How many right angles are there in this name? We can see there is only one right angle. Now, how many acute angles are there in the name? We can see there are only 6 acute angles. Now, what about the obtuse angle? There are 4 obtuse angles. In the name Aman, there are total 11 angles, out of which you can see one angle is right angle in the letter M. 6 angles are acute angle and 4 angles are obtuse angle. If you are still confused, you can take help of your angle tester to see the types of angle in this name. Would you like to try one more time? Let us now write the name of a girl. Write the name Rakhi. Now, this name has 5 alphabet: R, A, K, H, I. This name has total number of angle 20. There are 6 angle in letter R. There are 3 angles in letter A. There are 3 angles in letter K. There are 4 angles in letter H. And there is 1 letter in angle I. There are 4 angles in 1 letter I. Once again, count the number of right angle. The number of right angles are total 12. The number of acute angle are 6. And the number of obtuse angles are 2. Now you can start writing your own name. Take a colored sheet, put Fevicol on the matchstick and paste them on the sheet according to the spelling of your name. Make sure there is no curve. You have to use matchsticks without any curve, like a straight line. So, take 5 to 10 minutes and paste all the matchsticks according to your name. Now mark the angles between these matchsticks with the help of sketch pen. Don't be in a hurry. Keep it safe. Now, count the total number of angles in your name. Like, my name is Geetanjali. There are total 30 angles in my name, out of which there are 22 right angles, 4 acute angles, and 4 obtuse angles present in my name. So this will be a great activity, and after finishing this, you can paste this activity on your wall. Once you have finished counting, you will be happy to see your name and the angles. You can also prepare some angle names of your friends and family member. This can be a nice gift for your friends too. I hope you have enjoyed this activity. Since you already have matchsticks, we can have one more activity with them. In case if you have used all the matchsticks, I would suggest you to bring some more matchsticks for the activity. For our next activity, we need matchsticks that can be used or fresh, and small rubber tubes that you might have used in your cycle valves. In case you cannot get the rubber tubes, you can also use straw in small pieces. So let's start our activity. First of all, you have to clean the black end of the matchstick. Secondly, cut small pieces of tube in about 1 cm. Third, push 2 matchsticks in each end of the rubber tube. It would look like a joint made by you to make the matchstick longer. Fourth point, Now make different shapes by joining matchsticks. For example, by joining two matchsticks, you can make a longer line. By joining three matchsticks, you can make a triangle. So you can start making a triangle having three sides. Use four matchsticks to make another quadrilateral. Likewise, you can use 5, 6, 7, 8 matchsticks to make different figures. Now find out the number of angles in each figure. Mark all the angles in the figures you have made. And now answer the question. A triangle having 3 matchsticks has dash angles. That means a triangle having 3 matchsticks has 3 angles. The figure with the 4 matchsticks looks like the figure you already knew, as the matchsticks are of same size. This figure looks like a square. This square has 4 angles. The figure with the 5 matchsticks is called pentagon, having 5 angles. And the figure with the 6 matchsticks is also called hexagon, which is having 6 angles. Now let's try one more condition. Hold each figure on the floor and put pressure on any of the angle through your fingers. Can the pressure of your fingers changing its shape? Try on square. Is the square changing its shape? Do this activity with all four figures you have made. Except triangle, all other figures are changing their shapes due to the pressure. Triangle is the only shape that do not change its shape, which means it can handle the pressure better than any other shape. This is the reason the shape of triangle is used in making the towers, bridges, etc. The bridges to cross the river, the huge pole to transmit electricity in villages and towns, the top of the temple, the pyramids of Egypt, all are the example where we can see the triangle that has a special place because it can bear pressure and it will not change its shape. Now, I would like you to look around and find out more places where triangles are used. There is one more place you can see the use of triangles, that too 24/7. It has hands that keep us moving. It tells us to wake up. It tells us to eat. It tells us sleep on time. We can be late if its machine is not fine. Can you guess what is it? Try. It is our clock. Yes, our very own clock. Our clock has angles too. All of you have made angle tester already in your previous session. So can you bring that angle tester with you? What are we going to do? We are making a clock without numbers. Yes, a clock without numbers. For this, you need a plate, your angle tester, or if you don't have that, take 2 spoons or 2 pencils or 2 matchsticks. Now place the plate gently on the floor. Put your angle tester at the center. Now open the hands to make right angle open at your right hand. In case you don't have the angle tester, place 2 spoon in shape of L in your plate. Look at that carefully. Can you tell the time the hands of the clock showing? As you can see, the hands are opened at the right side of your hand. The time they are showing is 3 o'clock. If the same right angle is opened on your left hand side, what will be the time then? It will be 9 o'clock. If you know the angles, you can tell the time even if the clock doesn't have numbers. If we talk about the real clock, can you count the intervals one right angle has? Let's say, how many intervals are there in 3 o'clock? That is the gap between minute hand and hour hand. There are 3 intervals of 15 minutes in every right angle. Use your angle tester or spoon in your plate and make some more examples of right angle in the clock. Let's test your previous learning. Question number 1. If the hour hand is at 7 and the minute hand is at 5, can you tell the type of angles it makes on the clock? Since the angle is less than right angle, it is an acute angle. Can you also read the time in this? Yes, it is 7 hours 25 minutes. Now you should try some more questions to read the time and angles. Can you tell the angle made by the hands of clock at 5 p.m.? The hour hand will be at 5 and the minute hand will be at 12. So the number of intervals are more than 3. There will be 5 intervals from 12 to 5. So it is an obtuse angle. Name the angle made at 10 minutes to 12. Can you read this time? Yes, it is 11 hours 50 minutes. So there are 2 intervals between the hour hand and minute hand. Hence, it is acute angle. Now, for today, your homework is to draw the hands of clock when they make angles less than right angle, more than right angle, and right angles. This will be a great fun. You can make it a puzzle by changing the hands and finding the names of the angles. This will also help you to read the time of your clock. Now, this is it for today. I want you to find out the structures and places where triangle is used. Today, we have seen various types of angles in our surroundings. Angles that are present in leaves, flowers, branches, rays of the sun, etc. These angles can be divided into 3 special categories: right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle. We have also seen all 3 angles in our name. At the end, we came to know that angle changes their shapes by putting pressure, but there is a figure that do not change its shape even after putting pressure on it. That is the triangle. You must have seen the game of making pyramid with the playing cards. The most repeated shape we have there is also triangle. We have also learned to read the angles made between the hands of the clock. Right angle in the clock, less than right angle, and more than right angle in the clock. So I hope you will find more angles by observing things around you. Keep observing. Have a good day. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. प्रोडक्शन असिस्टेंट्स मीनाक्षी कुकरेती, तनु गुप्ता एंड जगबंधु जाना. रिकॉर्डेड बाय बटी लैंगलिंगडो एंड प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अजीत होरो. दिस प्रोग्राम वॉज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय CIET NCERT न्यू दिल्ली इंडिया.